Welcome. Before starting, I warn you not to try to repair high or low voltage equipment yourself if you don't have the necessary skills. As you will see in this video, even a simple emergency light can prove to be very dangerous. 2 years ago, I bought this cheap emergency light to install it in an unimportant part of the house, but after a year after the first blackout, I realized that it no longer worked. Today, I will try to fix it with you. When I plug in the power light does not turn on. When you turn on the light, the LEDs light up and they all seem to work. Let's take it apart and take a look inside. It doesn't bode well. I immediately notice a very dangerous thing: there is no transformer. Mains voltage is present on the circuit. There are three 4-volt lead batteries placed in parallel. One of these seems to have exploded and has left a burn mark on the body. The others don't seem to be damaged but have the wires detached from corrosion. Perhaps that's why they didn't explode. Let's get the batteries out of the way. The circuit is badly damaged. Several resistors are cooked and the single electrolytic capacitor is swollen. I absolutely don't like this circuit. It's not isolated from the mains, it has bad battery charge management, excessive consumption, and I don't intend to repair it. I turn it back on, but this time I will use an isolation transformer with protection. The circuit supplies the LEDs with 2.7 volts, now I can eliminate it. We disassemble the LEDs to see the circuit. There are 42 LEDs, all in parallel. There is no code to be able to trace their characteristics. Let's try experimentally to supply 20 milliamps per LED. I supply the LEDs with constant current. We start with a total of 840 milliamperes. The voltage drops to 4 volts. I increase with the amperes until I reach 4.3 volts and I obtain a total consumption of 1 ampere, which is 24 milliamperes per LED. And the light is not bad. I could power the LEDs directly with a battery and they shouldn't burn. Let's try to make this circuit. I'm going to use a PNP transistor to turn the LEDs on when the light goes out. I won't put any resistors in series because the voltage should drop to 3.5 volts and it shouldn't damage the LEDs, even though they won't be very bright. Be careful, this circuit is not suitable to fix all lights but will have adapted on a case-by-case basis. Let's recycle the switch and the network connector. Thank you. I disassemble the circuit of an old mobile phone charger. The dimensions are perfect and it will supply us with the 5 volts we need. I connect the power supply to the old main socket. Let's cut some support to fit the new components. Thank you. Let's connect the 5-volt output of the power supply to the input of the charge regulator. I connect the battery to the charge controller by first passing through the switch. I connect the power being careful with the power supply because it has components connected to the mains. Even if I am using an isolation transformer, it is still dangerous. The regulator indicates that the battery is charging. I solder the transistor and the two resistors directly above the LEDs. The two resistances will be calculated according to the transistor you use. Let's test. Everything seems to work as expected, and the voltages are correct. Let's block all the components with hot glue and close. Final test passed. And the light and duration is sufficient for the place I will use it.